What's up, guys? Shane here from Team COG, and I'm coming at you with a combo video on my Master Rule 5 Utopia Gagaga blah 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 deck profile on a Monotopia. So, this deck is something that I really like. It's got a lot of nostalgia for me, as Zexal was one of the was at about the same time that I came back into the game. So, I built this deck after the new. I heard about the new Master Rule, and they also released the new Legacy support for it. The new Legacy support is busted, but it also requires that you have the Utopic Onomatopoeia card, which is really important for the combos. There's ways to get around it, but it is kind of the one size fits all for the deck. So, a lot of the combos really do revolve around him. So, we're going to just grab them out real quick. So. We'll grab out Utopic, Onomatopoeic, Zubaba Poncho, Dododo Dwarf, and then, yeah, that's all we should need. We'll grab this out real quick, and then I will explain to you basically the only real combo. The combos basically streamline as soon as you get these three monsters into your hand. There's a few other variations I've discovered while playtesting just because of how these cards interact, and I can show you in a minute, but give me just a second. So, we're going to start with two cards in hand and a card for discard fodder. We'll just put that there. This won't matter at all, so I'm going to keep this card face down. Activate Onomatopoeia pickup. Pickup will search Onomatopoeia. Making sure you guys can see all the cards real quick. Onomatopoeia. Para discards the random card. And no matter which what, you're going to be searching the card that you're missing in hand. Or the two cards that are missing in hand. So you can add up to two of different archetypes. So these guys count as two different archetypes in themselves. So this is a Gogogo and a Dododo. And this is a Zubaba and a Gagaga. And this guy is literally anything you want him to be. So that's great. So, first of all, the best and easiest way to go about this is normal summoning him. And then his effect will summon the two from hand. Another way is if you have another Gagaga in hand, say the Gagaga Magician, because that's really the only other Gagaga you're playing. You can normal summon this, special summon this, and then you can summon. Yeah, it's a little bit rough. But basically, this is going to be your combo with these three guys. Summon him, summon these two in defense. You'll overlay here for this. And the deck is going to be shuffled, so whatever my draws are will be completely random. I did not order them in a specific way, so hopefully it works out. So we will detach the two for Dugarris. Dugarris is probably your best number monster, mostly because he detaches and puts both of these into hand or into graveyard. The draw is relatively pointless, but it is always nice to have more cards in hand. So we get to see one. And two. So we'll discard the Onomatopoeia, because Onomatopoeia is not going to do us as much, unfortunately. We'll do Foolish Burial just for giggles and shits. And let's go ahead and send summon a Gagaga, send a Gagaga Magician to grave. We'll send the Gagaga to grave. To be honest, actually, now thinking in retrospect, you might want to keep this in hand for next turn so that you do have a follow-up. So what we're going to do is we're going to put the Gagaga Magician back and discard the Foolish Burial and Onomatopoeia in the hand. Unfortunately, I don't think we're going to be able to get very far with this because we did not start with a full hand, but that's not important. What is important is what we can do with what cards we did have. So, special summon using Zubaba Poncho to summon Onomatopoeia, and then Dododo Dwarf in Grave will activate its effect, summoning it in defense. Then we can overlay. Now, you'll want a combo continuer, Zubab, or XYZ change tactics, or something like that. In this situation, the best you're probably going to end up doing is Giant Hand or Buguska. Right now, we will keep this guy here, because if we don't, we don't really get much chance. We're going to go risk it for the biscuit, as Charles would say, and go Crazy Box. Right, Kayate. Crazy Box activate. It's a one. So I have my life points. Awesome. Detaching Zubaba. So at this point, we're kind of bucked. We don't have any cards in hand, and we don't have anything really on board to make a big difference. So that was a terrible, terrible way to show that. I don't know where I went wrong, but usually you see a continuer card off of Dugarris, but both cards we saw were pretty bad. So hope to see an XYZ change tactics or something along those lines next time. That's really a bad way to say that, but it's true. Anyway, let's just go on to test hands, and hopefully we can see a little bit better results. Basically, you cycle through that combo quite a bit. Basically, you need extenders in order to finish it off, though. It's supposed to put you into extenders, or you have extenders in your opening hand. So these are mostly going to be test hands rather than real combos, but you should be able to see some combos play out. So, Dododo Dwarf, Monster Reborn, Astral Force, Onomatopoeia, and Gagaga Child. So right off the bat, we discard the Onomatopoeia. We discard the Child. Actually, yeah, we'll discard the Child, searching and adding the Onomatopoeia and the Zubababancho. Zubababancho. Gosh. The coat. Anyway, normal summoning the Onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia's effect to summon these two back. Right away we have Astral Force, so that's not a big deal. We know we're going to end up with a Zexal right away. So what we'll do is we'll go here, we'll overlay these two guys, and go Dugarris. Dugarris is a really good card. If you don't own a couple copies, I suggest picking up a couple, because he is really fucking good. Detach two to draw two and discard one. So draw, draw. That's not bad. Discard the Dododo Dwarf. We don't need it in hand. If it was a Zubaba Bancho, I would say keep it in hand, but it's not. Because activate reinforcements of the army and go ahead and search out another Zubaba Bancho. Go coat. So this guy will be able to trigger right away. Not right away. Activate Bancho. Bancho will summon back the Onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia is on board. We qualify for the effect of Dododo Dwarf. Let's go ahead and use Dododo Dwarf's effect. We can go ahead and summon out the Gagaga from hand. If you had anything else, you could probably summon differently, but overlay. Now it doesn't really matter. So we'll overlay right here. So this is how you would hard make it if you didn't open the Astral Force. So you'd make a couple XYZs, and then you'd fast start, basically much. Let's go Utopia Double. Utopia Double can be negated. For just max XYZ materials for this guy, we will actually do Utopia Double. It doesn't matter, really. Nah. To deck, then, we'll use Utopia Double, Detach. Make sure you end up with a Giga Coat and a Dododo Glove. Dododo Dwarf, Engrave. Add the Double or Nothing. Remember, this can get ashed, so if it does, you really just end up with one less material, but it also thins your deck quite a bit. So, we'll throw number 39 Utopia on there. He's 5k. Throw Utopia the Shining. Or Utopia Prime, and then we discard the Astral Force. Zexal. Zexal's on board. Now we overlay two level fours here, and we go Baguska. Just kidding. We go Giant Hand. Giant Hand, quick effect, target, negate. As long as it's on board, it's negated. And that's pretty much it for that turn. We'll do another quick combo or another quick test hand, and then that should be it for the video. Unfortunately, that one test hand didn't go too well. I did record this once already. Sorry if I sound a little sick. I am. It's not coronavirus, don't worry. I have plenty of rolls of toilet paper, so there's no way I could get the coronavirus, but I am a little sick, so sorry about the stuffed up part. If you guys are interested in the deck profile, there is a few changes to this deck profile, but I will be linking it in the top right corner here, or top left, top right. And if you click that, I probably linked it right at the beginning of the channel, or the video too. So go ahead and click that, watch through that, skim through that. Comment, like, subscribe, obviously. We should be putting out our new mats in no time flat. I'm still working on that, so let's see what we've got. We've got Onomatopoeia, Zubaba Bancho, Monster Reborn, Onomatopera, and Called by the Grave. So, because we have Monster Reborn, I'm going to discard the Onomatopera. Discard the Zubaba Bancho with the Onomatopera. We'll add Utopic and the Dwarf. We will be able to make it because of the extenders we have. Also, if the Ash called by. Ha! We'll say that the Ash called by. Haha. We win. Meta play, just in order to get the card out of our hands so that we're not playing with extra resources that we might not have. So, Onomatopoeia, Special Summoning the Dwarf, Monster Reborn to bring back the Zubaba Gaga Coat, Opeia, Activate, Overlay. We will go Dugarris because more resources is always a good thing. Dugarris the Timeless. Detach 2, discard one, draw 2, discard 1. Onomato Pickup and Upstart Goblin. Well, last time I did this, I Upstart Goblin into this. So, but I'm still going to do it because there's no reason to keep this as we've already used both the cards. This can search as well as it can search the field spell that you guys can't see. So, we're going to discard this because there's nothing we can search with that is better than what we can get off of this. So, Upstart Goblin, they gain 1,000, we draw, Gaga Magician. Nice. So, what we will do is Boncho will summon out his use his effect to summon from grave, and then Dododo Dwarf will return from grave due to the fact that he there is a Dododo on board. Dododo Dwarf's effect to summon the Gagaga Magician, or put this up here. Yep, that works. To summon the Gagaga Magician out of my hand. Now everything on this board is dead, so we're gonna go here. Hopefully they don't copyright strike me for the Mortal Kombat X music playing in the background. Real quick, we will go Utopia Double. Utopia Double detached to search. Just to get the double or nothings out of the deck and do a quick shuffle. Utopia Double will add one, and then the Utopia being summoned will add another. So everything's gaining 400 attack points, which is a pretty decent boost, but not amazing. Overlay two level fours. We will use one of our more expendable level fours with Silent Honor Arc. Everything in here is good, but everything also is kind of expendable. Actually, what we will do is we will go Crazy Box. We'll keep this in hand. I was about to say we'll set it just in case Crazy Box tries to blow something up, but we want to be able to discard it in case we get Onomatopeia. So we'll detach. Really shouldn't at this point. There's no point. Just shit giggles and shites. We got a four. Negate the effects of one face-up card in the field until the end of this turn. We'll target Crazy Box. Now a 3K beater, and then we'll just overlay these three right here. So throw those guys all together. Throw these in the grave. All we've got is a double or nothing. This has two counters on it. And we summon out number S0 Utopic Zexal. Yuma going Super Saiyan. Let's all be honest. All right. So next turn we will detach this. Your opponent can literally do nothing but set stuff. Hopefully you're not playing Altergeist because they really kind of fudge your baskets. Zexal is then reduced to basically nothing. 2K. Next turn we draw a card. And then we will activate this by removing two counters. Do nothing to summon out Onomatopoeia. Then let's go ahead and activate Pot of Desires. Do a quick shuffle a little bit. Ten. Resolve to draw two. Auto pickup and called by the grave. With our double or nothing, let's activate pickup. Wow. I guess we will add another onomatopoeia because that's all we can add. We will use the effect of Dododo Dwarf. To summon it back. Effect of Dododo Dwarf to summon the Utopic from hand. Overlay two level fours here. We were able to search through the deck to see if there was another double or nothing. So make sure to keep track of that when you do that. So detach, search, add double or nothing. I did not put that intentionally on the bottom, have everybody know that. This adds 1/2. Because now it summons out a Utopia beat stick. And now we will go battle phase with Utopia declaring for 54. Use its effect to negate the attack and double or nothing. And if that doesn't kill them, we attack with Zexal. Declare for 24. Negate the attack with Utopia again and then double or nothing. Ha ha ha. We win. Maybe not, maybe. We have it called by the grave, so. Woo. The deck is surprisingly consistent. I built it as for fun. It does lose to things like impermanence. Going second, it always has the Utopia double option, but it is quite solid. There's a lot of stuff you can do to get one or two monsters on board, but there's not a lot you can do to get more than that. So, Utopia doubles your going second option. Utopic Zexal is your going first option. The deck has a lot of opportunities. The biggest ability it has is stun factor. Not a lot of people know how to play against any of these cards, and they're really going to be very confused as you go and summon all of these really hard to say names on them. So not a lot of people are going to read these. Like, even this thing's super cringy. Like, it gains high five the sky counters every time a Utopia is summoned. So yeah, it's pretty rough to like be your opponent because not a lot of people want to read all of this stuff, but it is really good, really good effects, and the surprise factor will really get you quite a few games.